Round two tanning. It's early, it's 6 a.m. I went ahead and I rinsed off. I didn't scrub, I rinsed off my liquid sunray tan that they did yesterday. And now I'm getting a light coat done in the morning and letting that sit all the way in through prejudging before they start glazing and all that good stuff. So this is the way that I've been doing it for years, using liquid sunrays, and it always seems to work fabulously. Final meal before we leave to prejudging. It's 8 o'clock right now. 1.5 scoops of whey, 2 tablespoons of peanut butter, same as my pre-workout, salted, and keep it nice and simple. We know that this, I can get a pump with this because of what I look like in the gym. So it shouldn't be a problem backstage once I start moving blood around. This is it, last meal. Here we go, drive to the prejudging. We're trying to be as calm as possible right now. A little John Legend in the background just soothing us.
DJ Carlos.
And we'll see how things go. Backstage. Women are in 5 minutes, they start. They got women's physique. They got women's fitness and women's figure. And then us. So this is what the backstage looks like. It's only 2 of us back here right now. But it's they have it sorted out in like sections. So this is like a holding room. Then we have a section where we go to get oil. Then there's an actual pump up area with like weights and stuff, which is cool. And finally they have us line up. That's basically it. So I have with me, what I do is I time my, like my pump stuff that I take before I start pumping up. And what it is 50 grams of cyclic dextrin. It's the Rise pre-workout and the Rise pump product that I've done already. And with that, I added a little bit of water, so it's like a little paste. And then I'll eat that when the division in front of me is starting. And I'm number 10 in my lineup. So I won't start pumping up until we start lining up and before the first guy starts going. So if everybody goes up, that's like a minute. That gives me almost 10 full minutes of pumping up straight. And that's definitely more than enough to get enough blood going. And then, you know, which is nice because you don't want to over pump, but you obviously don't want to under pump either. So I think 10 minutes is perfect. Here's my sludge, 50 grams of cyclic dextrin, some sodium, Rise pre and pump product right before we start pumping up.
Wow, brutal. Wow.
All right, guys, Pastor Pump.
Hey.
top six. We come back tonight to pose. So yeah, we did it. So the goal was made. We didn't get first call out, but there was only 3 guys in it. Yeah. But second call out, and we come back at night. So guaranteed top six.
Huge improvement from the last time that we did the Arnold, where we placed seventh, and this was the goal, was top six. So
in a better lineup.
In a better lineup. we're getting better. So now it's hydrate. We're hydrating, and we're gonna wait about an hour and gonna get some steak and fries and relax. Back at the Airbnb, it's time to eat and it's time to sleep until tonight. 6:30, we gotta be back at the venue. So it's noon right now. So I'm eating 8 ounces of steak with some Shake Shack fries and going right to sleep. And then wake up and reevaluate where I'm at from there. Well, after waking up, looking crazy, decided to go back to normal meals. Fats and protein, some salt, and some water. So here we go, the usual. 3 ounces of steak, 3 ounces of chicken, 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Right now it's 3:15. Gonna eat another meal at 6, right before heading to the venue. And finishing up this Arnold 2020 prep, in which I'll do a closing video. And if you guys already haven't noticed, this is, I'm compiling 2 videos in one day out, and show day is gonna be one video, just because they kind of all blended in together. So here we go, next meal.
Sixth place, Santiago.
Sixth place. Oh my God! Perfect.
Wow! Congratulations, Santiago.
Stage right. With the classic physique champs right here, and we have a toast. Our first. Reese's Pieces. This is the white one, right? This is the white chocolate.
This is the
Reese's.
First toast of the night.
This is the toast. Cheers, guys. Wow. Victory never tasted so good. Nice. Congratulations. Everybody come in. Cheers. Yeah, we're cheersing.
Oh, I'm so late. Bro. Give me
you're
a second.
Late. You're late.
Fuck. We're it's starting to crumble.
We're cheersing. Cheers. Cheers.
Oh, look at that.
Oh. sushi celebration. I'm fucking starving.
Yeah, boy.
And then I still have the rest of your rolls coming. Just brought this first.
That's fine.
We got more.
Boat's almost done. More rolls.
Kisses, baby.
Cream brulee.
All right, guys. So this is the final clip of the Arnold prep peak week, whatever you want to call it. This is the last, finally, the last clip. And this is a conclusion of my entire experience. What I thought about the weekend, what I thought about how I looked, what I thought about the results, etc. So all in all, you know, I'm obviously very happy and very grateful that I had the opportunity to compete in this Arnold Classic. This was a very interesting one, considering the circumstances of the whole situation with the Arnold Classic, where it was canceled and the expo, there was no expo, and you couldn't have spectators at the pre-judging, and just a complete shit show. And none of it's the fault of the actual Arnold Sports Festival. It has to do mostly with politics and the state government of Ohio. But it was an interesting experience because it's never happened before, and I competed in that one Arnold Classic where all of this did happen. So it was not a usual Arnold Classic. I've been to about 5 of them already, and this was, I mean, look at the town is dead. It's like a ghost town everywhere that you go. Powerhouse. You could get machines at Powerhouse and actually train. That's unheard of when the Arnold Expo is going on. So it was a missed opportunity to actually connect with a lot of the fans, but I got plenty of love on social media, that's for sure. So much so that I can't even keep up with it. And I do, the ones that do watch my YouTube videos, I do apologize if I just did double tap whatever was sent to me. It was so overwhelming, and I have to be able to filter between, customers that are actually Paragon customers and, a lot of fans that, are sending videos of the posing routines or whatever it may be. And I go ahead and I repost it. But it's very difficult to get to everybody and actually still have a life. But I greatly appreciate it all. Now, I want to quickly thank the people that surrounded themselves, that I was able to surround myself around this prep. Most importantly, my two coaches, Arnold, my two coaches for the Arnold, Andrew Vu and Pastor Punk Carlos Rodriguez. They pushed me. They took me mentally to the next level on this prep, and I wouldn't have been able to do it without them. Especially all my special thanks to all my sponsors that were involved. Most notably, MegaFit, Rise, XT Labs, and YoungLA. They all played a huge, huge part in my prep. A lot of support, a lot of love coming from them. And all my friends and family. I mean, these are the people that I have to live through this prep with me every single day. My girlfriend Laura, my parents, all my friends back at home. It's very difficult to balance yourself between the mindset of a champion and also the being emotionally involved with family members and loved ones, because you're just so focused and trying to get to this ultimate goal. So it's going to be nice now for about a week to kind of defuse and relax a little bit and give back to them a little bit what I've been not giving them throughout this prep, you know, attention, some love, and normal Santi for a little bit. It's always nice to be myself for a little bit. I don't even like being the person that I am so close to a show, but it's temporary and they understand it. But it's definitely a mindset that you have to put yourself in to get yourself through this. Now, as far as how I felt that I looked for the show and stuff like that, everybody's their worst critic. I think that I could have been much better, you know. I think that I'm still trying to figure out this classic physique division. It's crazy that my body can look a certain way, and then all of a sudden, in a flip of a switch, things change very drastically. I don't know if it has to do with the stress going into the show, my nerves, but I'm gonna figure it out. Certainly didn't have to do with the food, because I wasn't eating very much before the prep, and I was looking fine. And I pretty much ate the same stuff, and the body looked much different. So I think it mostly has to do with stress. Doesn't have to do with rest and sleep, because I slept a shit ton in between meals and everything. So I think it has to do a little bit with the water, with the salt going into weigh-in, and then obviously the nerves, the stress. So I should start smoking more weed. Calm my ass down. Drink a bottle of CBD. So yeah, the plan is to just continue to improve going into Pittsburgh. That's the next show. It's in 8 weeks. And, you know, hopefully I have the energy to continue to do these videos that are more personal. My YouTube videos are a little bit more personal than my Instagram stuff that I post, just because I can rant for about 7 minutes at a Kroger while I drink a flat white. Oh my god, this is so fucking good. Well, with that being said, guys, again, this is the final clip of the whole Arnold, and I thank you guys for taking the journey with me. And go ahead and go on my Instagram page, because now that's where I'm going to be posting mostly. YouTube videos are secondary for me. My main stuff is all on my Instagram. So again, thank you guys, and I'll see you soon.